Atahualpa was the last Inca emperor. After defeating his brother, Atahualpa became very briefly the last Sapa Inca or sovereign emperor of the Inca Empire before the Spanish conquest ended his reign. Before the Inca emperor, Huayna Capac died in Quito in 1524, possibly due to smallpox, a disease brought by Europeans. He had appointed his son Ninan Cuochi as his successor. Ninan died of the same disease. The Cusquenian nobles named Huascar, another son of Huayna, as sovereign emperor, and he appointed his brother Atahualpa as governor of Quito. The Inca civil war began in 1529 when Huascar declared war on Atahualpa for fear that he would try to carry out a coup d'etat against him. Atahualpa became Inca emperor in May 1532 after he had defeated and imprisoned Huascar and massacred any pretenders to the throne. The Inca people named their empire, Land of the Four Quarters, or Tihuatansuyu, and in 1533 it was the largest in the world. It covered 2,500 miles and stretched from southern Colombia in the north to central Chile in the south. It rose between 1200 and 1300 AD in the valley of Cusco, an increase in temperatures allowing the Inca to inhabit ever higher altitudes and produce agricultural surpluses. The astonishing site of Machu Picchu is evidence of this. The empire successfully built a road network of 14,000 miles and 10 million people lived within its borders. So how did a mere 200 Spanish conquistadors capture its emperor god Atahualpa and conquer an entire empire on August 29, 1533? In reality, a number of factors brought down this powerful empire, so wealthy contemporaries remarked that its people walked on sandals lined with silver. Since the arrival of the Spanish conquistadors in the Americas, Western diseases had steadily weakened native populations. The Inca Empire had been especially struck by smallpox, which had reduced the population by an estimated two-thirds and claimed the life of Atahualpa's father, the Emperor Huayna Capac. After his father's death, Atahualpa waged a civil war against his half-brother, Huascar, that lasted 6 years. A war he had only just won when he encountered Francisco Pizarro in 1532. Pizarro and his small force of mercenaries were clearly inspired by the success of Hernán Cortés in Mexico. In a daring ambush on November 16, 1532, Pizarro and his men surprise Atahualpa and his lightly armed followers in the town square of the city of Cajamarca. Within an hour they shot and killed 5,000 of his men, sparing only Atahualpa himself. Pizarro had realized Atahualpa was more valuable to him alive than dead. With Atahualpa captive, his generals did not dare to attack, and the emperor then convinced his captors to ransom him for a room filled with gold and silver. Once the treasure was gathered, the Spanish refused to release Atahualpa and gave him the choice of being burnt alive, a pagan's death, or to convert to Christianity and have the kinder death of strangulation. Atahualpa chose the latter and was garroted on August 29, 1533 and given a Christian burial. Various accounts had his remains later dug up, mummified and reburied. With Atahualpa's death, the empire collapsed and the Spanish consolidated their power over the Inca by marching on the capital, Cusco, and installing their own puppet emperor. A famous hoard of treasure that never made it in time for Atahualpa's ransom supposedly lies hidden to this day in the Andes. The city of Machu Picchu remained undiscovered by the Spanish and was eventually abandoned by the Inca. Its existence became widely known only when it was rediscovered by the American explorer Hiram Bingham in 1911. Thank you for watching till the end. Please consider encouraging us by subscribing to our channel. In order to show your support, don't forget to like and share the video.